To the finale of American Circus's Perspective series. In today's episode, we'll be taking a look at some of the more interesting ideas that Americans are holding in relationships and in life. All right, let's get into it.
Do you know what's crazy? I have men in my DMs, like guys with check marks with money, status, and influence that say they have problems with child custody. That's they send me their stories. And these are men with money. So what does that mean for the average guy? In my opinion, the only way to do that is to get rid of birth control. I don't think it'll ever go back unless that's gone.
That's an interesting point.
Because that's when you see everything switch. If you look at the divorce rate graph, like as soon as divorce spiked at the same time, that was when more women were getting on birth control. Because you're taking away, because that's the thing, like society takes away the consequence for everything women do. Like we have no consequences for anything. If we sleep around, we don't get pregnant because of birth control. Even if we do get pregnant, we have abortion. Even if we do get pregnant and keep the kid, he pays child support. Even if we do get pregnant, get married, get divorced, we get alimony or child support again.
Yeah.
And it's like, even if we're bad with our finances and we're homeless, there's women's shelters.
The man said he liked you.
Yes.
And he dated you for a month.
Yes.
How long before you were intending to have sex with him? He's 30 years old. He's not a virgin. Ballpark it for me.
Maybe 2 months in.
Did you tell him that?
No, I told him I had bad experiences with men in the past.
Well, there you go. Ding, 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 ding. Making a man in your present pay for stuff in your past equals no future.
It's interesting how quickly we can forget the ramifications of our past on our future.
When women deal with the same type of and they get screwed over, they keep blaming all ain't shit. That's the go-to.
Oh, every a cheater.
But when a man gets finessed by a woman or a woman uses a man, you know what they tell men? You should know better. Like, she finessed you. Like, so men got to take accountability for when we get finessed. But when y'all constantly get finessed, ain't shit.
You want to know why?
Did you sleep with him or just kiss him?
I slept with him.
Okay, fine.
For like 10 seconds. And then I stopped it and I came straight back to you. I don't know. Maybe this was just one crazy moment before us. Because I love you, Joshua. I love you.
That's not love. That's guilt. Love is trust.
No, it is.
That's all it is. That's the only currency, and you broke it.
A woman that's in high demand, her mindset is three main things. She's cooperative, she's smart, and she's agreeable. See, all three of those things must be there. She must be smart, but a woman that's smart and disagreeable is not a woman that's in high demand. She's not a woman that's really wanted. A woman who's smart and cooperative, but not agreeable, is kind of useless. Because she'll only cooperate when she agrees. A woman who's cooperative and agreeable, but not smart, is also kind of just blind leading the blind. She must be smart, cooperative, and agreeable.
Not just in America, but everywhere in the world. When it comes to trust and love, hope, all of these virtues are things that should be aspired for, longed for, desired, worked towards. What I think is so peculiar about the times we're living in and the American society is the fact that so many people are willing to spend thousands of dollars to go somewhere else and do exactly to other people in different parts of the world the very things that they claim to detest that are happening here.
If you're a Westerner and you're traveling the world, you have to understand that you're rich comparatively, they're poor, and they're gonna add some rich person tax on top, and the best thing you can do is pay it anyway and not be a dickhead. But this bitch, excuse me, you tried to charge me too much money for my tea. And this Nepalese girl must have been like, you want to fucking fly or middle class ass over to my part of the world, to my mountains, drink my tea, and then flex over the price? I've had enough. Picked up a machete and said, bitch, you're gonna die if you don't pay for this tea. I like that. All these motherfucking travelers, I've done videos on travelers before, picking up $2,000 in savings and fucking off to the other side of the world, to the poor part of the world, and just sitting there for 7 months in a row, being as frugal as possible, squeezing every penny out of the poor people who live there.
Women confuse this very often. They talk about the fact that men have all the power, men make all the money, men are in charge, and we oppress women. Let me make something very clear to you.
Okay.
Firstly, you're confusing 1% of men with all men. The majority of men have no money, no power, no sex from their wife, no fucking chance in court. They can't even keep their house. They won't get to see their kids, and they don't. So most men, their life sucks. That's the first thing. The second thing, when a man gets up at 4 a.m. to go carry garbage to earn a good wage, he ain't thinking, I'm gonna do this so I can oppress that bitch because she's broke. He's doing it thinking so I can provide for my family, so my woman can stay at home and raise my kids and have nice nails while I'm out here carrying trash. You go to a coal mine, those dudes are not down there thinking about oppressing women. They're down there thinking about providing for women. Okay. Now, I'm not saying that there's not bad apples, but in general, us men are prepared to take on more bullshit to protect you than you would possibly believe. And in the modern world, they've spun that. Feminism spun that. Men make all the men money. You women need more money because men make the money and men are in charge and men have the good jobs. Men are out here giving up their fucking life for you chicks.
Americans have so much, and yet I wonder why we seem to be so depressed, so unhappy. We tend to forget that we never know when our last day will be. When we might have an accident or something goes wrong. We get that diagnosis of cancer. Whatever you're going through in life, always count your blessings, because there's always someone who has it worse than you.